Hi, welcome back to another tutorial we've decided to make for Sam Broadcaster. We have a couple on the way, in English and Spanish. If there's any you'd like to see over the next couple of days, feel free to leave in the comments below as a request, and we're happy to work with you and make the video for you so it can be a great help. But in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to add your microphone as an option in Sam. Now, the cool thing about Sam is that we can just add our mic. Let's say it can be a Blue Yeti, or it can be a Sony mic or a Shure mic, as an input option, either be directly to the computer, or we can also use a mixer. In this case, I'm going to be showing you with the headset microphone I've got plugged into my computer directly, how to add it as an input to Sam. Another cool thing about Sam is that once we add the microphone, it automatically does the whole fading of music for us and all of that, with just a couple little touches on the settings, moving around a little bit, but it'll work great. So first, we're going to want to open up Sam. We're going to want to go to the voice effects option. If you don't have a voice effects option, I'm going to show you how you can add it. We're just going to remove it here from mine. We're going to click on Windows, and we're going to go down here where it says voice effects, and it automatically add it. You can go ahead and resize it. We have one of those videos showing you a little more about how to use the options in Windows and more like that. But for the most part, we're just going to be working with voice effects today. So first things first, we're going to want to go to config. And we're going to go here where it says primary sound card device. So right now, I'm using my microphone Logitech USB headset. We're going to just double click it. So this whole option right here is basically what I had said a little bit earlier ago about the music. We can fade in, fade out the music. We can click the buffer settings. We can move all of that. I normally just keep it as is and only mess around with this one that says music and mic volume. We're just going to click OK. So the recording sound card device or record sound card device, we normally select here, if it's not already default in Windows, our USB mixer, our Logitech headset, our Shure microphone, our Blue Yeti, things like that. But we normally just click it here, record sound card device, and we're going to click on OK. And then we're going to click on basically mic on, lock talk, and automatically. I'll just turn it off because it created a very long, big static for me. But basically what you just saw is that my microphone started picking up. Now, what we normally do or recommend clients do is first start playing a song and mic on lock talk and automatically open up from your phone or the website, the station, and you see how it sounds. If the music is too loud, which normally always will be, this option right here will fade the music for you. It'll automatically start fading it when you move it down. You can either go up if you like more louder, or if you want it to, I guess, not sound so loud, you can bring down that bar as well. So we normally keep it around here, or just raise it a little bit to maybe 10, 11, around there. We normally like to play around with it and see what's best, and it all depends on the song. Some songs are louder, and some songs sound lower. So it all depends. But for the most part, as well, for the microphone, if it's too loud, you can pretty much lower that as well. Or if it's too low, you can also get it. It gives it a little gain, a little boost, and it doesn't cause that much of a saturation. But basically, this is how to add it to Sam Broadcaster, your mic as an input. It'll automatically start picking it up here. On my end, it created that big old static that nobody really likes to hear. but on your end, it shouldn't do that. And if it does, feel free to leave me a comment. I'm happy to help out with any questions. And one more thing I do want to mention is if you do use sound effects, remember that, so for the music, only controls deck A and deck B, the music. You also would have to lower the volume for sound effects. If you want to use, for example, you're doing a live show and you'd like to use applause or Boeing or Dejong or Eagle, you have to lower that from here as well. So that's the only way to only do the sound effects. And then for music, you would just handle the music. But hopefully this video was of help. If you have any questions, like I said, feel free to leave them in the comments below, and I'm happy to help. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.